Good morning, students. How are you? Hope all of you are fine and doing well your studies at home. In our previous videos, we have started the numerical questions of chapter 7, Accounting for Partnership Firms. The previous numericals we have discussed that was related to presence of partnership deed. We have discussed the numerical question interest on partner's loan that was in case when there was presence of partnership deed. Today we will discuss about the numerical question which is related to in case when there is absence of partnership deed. When there is partnership deed and there can be some provisions which are silent in the partnership deed. Okay. So there is a question. We will understood the concept with the help of numerical question. There is question regarding that A and B are partners sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 2:3. There are two partners A and B and they are sharing the profit and losses in the ratio of 2:3 with the capitals 2 lakh and 1 lakh. What is given? Here we will do the solution. What is given in the question, we will write here step by step. There is profit sharing ratio. Profit sharing ratio. There are two partners A and B. Okay. There are two partners A and B and they share the profits in the ratio of 2:3. And capital is rupees 2 lakh and what is the capital? Capital is by A that is 2 lakh and by B that is rupees 1 lakh. Okay. There are some points given to us that the profit first point is related to profit sharing ratio, that the profit sharing ratio is 2:3 and the capital is 2 lakh rupees 2 lakh and rupees 1 lakh. Okay. A has contributed the amount of capital rupees 2 lakh and B has contributed capital rupees 1 lakh. Next is on October 1st, 2018, A and B gave loans of rupees 4 lakh and 2 lakh. Okay, A and B. But they have given loan to firm. They have given loan to firm and A has given the loan of rupees 4 lakh and B has given loan of rupees 2 lakh. Okay. The partnership deed, PD means the partnership deed is silent on payment of interest on loan. What is another information? What is information given that partnership deed is silent on what concept it is silent? On payment of interest on loan. Okay. The partnership deed is silent on payment of interest on loan. So, what will be the concept if the partnership deed is silent? What will be the concept on interest payment? What will be the concept? There will be payment of interest on loan which is given by the partners. Okay. There will be payment of interest on loan at the rate 6% per annum. If the partnership deed is silent on payment of interest on partner's loan, then the interest will be paid at the rate 6% per annum. Why it is compulsory payment? Because interest on partner's loan, is a charge against profit. And revising the whole concept so that you can easily solve the numerical questions. Okay. Interest on partner's loan is charged against profit and it will be compulsory paid. It will be compulsory paid whether If the worm is facing the noses, if the worm is facing the noses, in that condition also, interstone partner stone will be paid. Okay. So the partnership deed was silent on payment of interest. Then there is a provision that the interest will be paid at the rate 6% per annum. Okay. So we have to calculate the interest on partner's loan and the remaining profit which will be distributed among the partners A and B. Okay, there are three cases given to us. That case one, if there is profit before interest payment is ₹25,000, then what will be the amount which will be paid to the partners? Okay, we have to calculate. What we have to calculate? Interest on partner's loan and the remaining profit which will be distributed among the partners. So there are three cases available with us. We will solve that step by step. So then we will start the interest on partner's loan. It will be paid at the rate 6%. Okay. Case first is, if the profit before interest payment is ₹25,000. Okay. What is the profit before interest payment? Interest payment is ₹25,000. Okay. Here we will calculate the interest on partner's loan. Okay. We will do the calculation of interest on partner's loan. Okay. Here we will calculate the interest on partner's loan. See, we will calculate the amount of interest which will be paid to A. What is the loan amount of A? That is 4 lakh. What is the rate? 6%. And for how many months it will be paid? It will be paid for the 6 months. Because the loan has given on October 1st and it is payable on 31st March. Okay. So, the amount will be, the interest will be paid for the 6 months. Okay. Here we will pay the interest for the 6 months. So what will be the amount of interest? It will come 12,000. It will come rupees 12,000 interest amount for A. Okay. Now we will calculate the amount of interest which will be paid to B. B has given the loan of rupees 2 lakh. The rate of interest is 6%. And for how many months it will be paid? For the 6 months, because B has also given the loan on October 1st. Okay. So October 1st to 31st March, there will be 6 months and the amount of loan will come. It will come rupees 6,000. Okay. So what will be the total amount of interest? What will be the total amount of interest which will be paid to A and B? It will come 12 plus 6, 18,000. So we have calculated the amount of interest on partner's loan which will be paid to A and B. Individually, to A it will be paid rupees 12,000. At the rate 6% per annum, and to B it will be paid 6,000. So total amount of interest is rupees 18,000, which the firm will pay to the A and B. So we will calculate here the remaining profit in case one. In case one, what will be the remaining profit? There is profit available with us is rupees. How much is the profit amount? That is 25,000. We have paid the amount of interest, that is 18,000. What is 18,000? 18,000 is interest on partner's loan. Okay. So what will left? 50 minus 7,000. The remaining profit will be 7,000, which will be distributed among A and B. It will be distributed among A and B. In which ratio it will be distributed? in 2:3, because the profit sharing ratio is given 2:3. So in case first, the remaining profit will be rupees 7,000, which will be distributed to A and B in the ratio of 2:3. Now we will discuss the case study. So now we will discuss the case second. What is case second? If the available profit before interest on partner's loan is rupees 15,000. Okay. Second case is that if the available profit before interest on partner's loan is rupees 15,000, then we have to calculate what will be the remaining profit which will be distributed to the partners. Okay. We have calculated in the case 1 the amount of interest. We have calculated the amount of interest on partner's loan. Okay. We have calculated the amount of interest on partner's loan in the case 1, and that has come. What was the amount? It was rupees 18,000 collectively. Okay. 12,000 was of A and 6,000 was of B. Okay. So this is the amount. It will be the same for all the three cases, because we have to calculate the remaining profit, distributable profit we have to calculate, that what will be the remaining profit which will be distributed among the partners if there is different conditions of available profit. Okay. In first case, there was available profit with us rupees 25,000. In second case, the available profit before interest on partner's loan is rupees 25,000. Here we have to calculate the remaining profit or loss which will be distributed among the partners. So, see what is the profit amount. Available profit is, what is the amount of available profit? It is rupees 15,000. Okay, and we will pay the interest on partner's loan. Interest on partner's loan is rupees 18,000. See, here the interest on partner's loan is more than the amount of available profit. Here the interest on partner's loan is more than the available profit, and I have told you this again and again that interest on partner's loan is charged against profit, so it will be compulsory paid. Okay, so in this condition, we will pay the whole amount of interest on partner's loan, and there will be occurrence of rupees 3,000 loss. We will show the loss. Okay, we will show the minus item in bracket, and this is a loss. In second condition, the firm will face the losses after paying the interest on partner's loan. So, what will be the remaining profit or loss? There will be loss, and it will be of rupees 3,000 after payment of interest on partner's loan. Okay. Now, we will discuss the case 3. What is there in case 3? If there is loss, okay. If there is loss before interest on partner's loan, and the loss is of rupees 25,000. The third case is related to loss, and this says that if firm is facing the losses before interest on partner's loan, and the loss amount is rupees 25,000. So tell me that in case of losses, interest on partner's loan will be paid or not? Interest on partner's loan will be paid or not? Yes, it will be paid. It will be, interest on partner's loan will be paid or not? This is the question here. That in case of losses, we will pay the interest or not, then it will be paid. Okay, because the same thing will be here, that why it will be paid? because interest on partner's loan is charged against profit. Because it is charged against profit, and we will pay this in case of losses also. So here see what will be the remaining, what will be the amount of exact loss. Okay, here we will calculate. Here available loss, here is the firm is facing the losses, and I will show the losses in the brackets. Okay, I am showing the losses in the bracket, and there is a loss of ₹25,000, and we will pay the interest on partner's loan. And what was the amount of interest on partner's loan? It was ₹18,000. Okay, here we will pay the interest on partner's loan. It will be deducted from the profit amount. So here is available losses. So what will be the total amount of losses? Total amount of loss after payment of interest on partner's loan, it will come ₹43,000. Okay, the remaining after payment of interest on partner's loan, there will be increase in amount of loss, and the total loss which will be which the partners will face, that is ₹43,000. Who are the partners here? A and B, and there is an agreement that they will share the profit or loss. This condition was related to both the conditions. Okay, this condition was related to both the conditions, profit or loss. Whatever will be the condition, if the firm will face the profits, then also they will share the profit in the 2:3. And if there is condition of this is loss, then also they will share in 2:3. Okay, so we have discussed the three questions. In case first there was available, there was the profits, and the profits were sufficient for the interest payment. In second case, there was profits, again there was profits, but the available profits were not sufficient, was not sufficient as per the amount of interest in partner's loan. And in third case, there was losses faced by the firm. So these three conditions we have discussed related to interest on partner's loan. Students, solve the numerical questions from your book. If you face any problem, you are free to ask, but at least you should try to solve the questions. Okay, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.